an MRI scan has become the key diagnostic test, the key test that doctor wants when thinking about MS. And the reason for that is that it's the only way of actually looking inside the brain of the person you're worried about. And in MS, there's very nearly always obvious signs of brain scarring. So little scars left over from attacks of inflammation in the brain in the past. And sometimes these scars are in such a particular pattern that we can say, well, that only ever happens in MS, so this person must have MS. The other thing that an MRI scan is useful for is not only doing one, but doing a second one and saying, well, what's happened in the intervening period of time? And sometimes you can see a new scar has popped up in a particular way that says, well, this must be MS. And that's it, no further tests are needed. It is irritating and annoying to have an MRI scan because it's quite unnatural. There's no pain involved as such, but you have to lie very still with your head clamped quite tightly. And when I first had an MRI scan, I thought, I really don't like this. You know, I'm feeling quite claustrophobic. Mm. And some people do feel very claustrophobic. And you have this big thing going over your head, and then there's this very strange banging noise that happens. You think, well, what on earth is that all about? But hopefully the person who puts you in the scanner will have explained all of this. And depending on exactly which bits of you are being looked at, an MRI scan can take as little as 10 minutes, but maybe as long as 20 or even 30 minutes. And sometimes, although this is decreasing in popularity, sometimes you have an injection of a dye during a scan. So halfway through, one of the team will come in and put a needle in your arm and inject some dye in to follow where the dye goes in the brain, which can sometimes be helpful. There's quite a debate now about how frequently people with MS should have MRI scans. Originally, they were used just at the time of diagnosis, but more and more, we're using them to monitor how active MS is, in particular when people are taking treatments. So if you put someone on a drug, which you hope will suppress inflammation due to MS, and you do a scan, say, a year later, you can see whether or not that drug's been effective. And that might lead to saying, well, actually, we see some new lesions on the scan. The drug's not as effective as we hope. Let's try another drug. So that would be the usefulness of it. And in some countries, people routinely have a scan every year with their MS. I think we haven't got that far with the NHS. There's not enough scanners, not enough capacity. But we are increasingly scanning people, particularly on treatment, to see whether the treatment's working. It's certainly reasonable to ask the question, would it be helpful for me to have a scan? If you're on a treatment, I think you can push really hard and say, I want a scan to see how effective my drug treatment is. And if it's been a long time since you've had a scan, I think it's very reasonable to ask the question.